Skylar Faith, ooh, behind the mask tonight. What episode are we on?
Episode 67!
Woohoo! That's unbelievable.
It's unbelievable. Episode 67, welcome to Randi's Live. It is Tuesday, 2 for Tuesday. We are so happy you're here with us. I can't believe we've gone to 67 consecutive shows from our home here in Nashville, Tennessee with my crew of three. This is my cameraman, my graphics department, sound engineer, talent booker, set design, mixing with McGinnis coordinator, Andrew McGinnis.
Yay!
And of course, my beautiful audience of one and stage manager, Skylar Faith McGinnis. We are so happy to have you here tonight with us. This has been a really beautiful way for us to build community, to reach out to our friends during this time. I started it one night when everything sort of shut down. I turned to Andrew and I said, I think we should go live every night. Thinking maybe we'd be at it like 2 weeks, and Andrew informed me it's been a little bit closer to maybe 10. But we've been happy to do it because every night we reach out to you guys, all of the viewers, which is makes our heart so happy. And then we also get to connect virtually with friends of mine from all over the world to see how everyone's doing, you know, to check in with everyone as we sort of go through this journey, this experience together, even though we're not all going through it the same way. I'm really touched by everyone that has reached out and everyone that's been available to pop on. And so, having said that, we are winding it down. We've been coming nightly, every night at 6 o'clock, even during a power outage, because Nashville has weather, you know. And it's been so joyful for our little family, but we're going to slowly taper it off. So this Friday will be our last nightly Randi's Live. And we have got quite a week for you because we want to make it like all about the last week of nightlies, but it won't be the last show. Saturday night we will do a house concert. I'll do a house concert right here from my living room with all of the songs that you guys have been requesting and all of the stories behind the song. I'm super happy and excited to do that. And then we'll be coming to you on a semi-regular basis. So we'll still do, it's hard to say, semi-regular basis. We'll still be coming to you to check in. It just won't be every single night for 365 days. Speaking of which, happy birthday to you. Aunt Sandra's birthday is today. What? We're going to see you later. We're going to check in with you virtually later for a cocktail, I hope. So happy birthday. And also, we can't forget Miss Doria. Julie Doria's birthday is also today. So happy birthday. I believe I saw maybe it's Catherine Beek's birthday, too. She was one of the Wednesdays with Women We Love guests. So lots of birthdays today, right after Memorial Day weekend. Joanne Ball is on. I'm so happy you could watch tonight. Hi, Michelle. Hi, Ryan. Hi, Rochelle. Hi, Marsha. Shauna. Marsha's winning for the first person on, I gotta tell you. And Donna. It's neck and neck. It's neck and neck. Wow, we have a show for you tonight. I'm so excited about the show that I put eyelashes on. That's right. I did. I'm not guaranteeing that they're gonna stay on, but I did. And I haven't done that in a long time. But I'm excited to have a great show for you. But we always start by telling you what we did today. Because when we started this show, we had really no content. We have no producers. We don't have to check with the network. It's really just us sitting at our kitchen table. But so we tell you what we did today to kind of, I don't know, have like a sense of normal check-in. Is that what we do?
Sure.
So what did we do today? We had breakfast. We did a lot of prepping for the rest of the shows this week. We're going to be doing a really fun look back. Andrew's very busy putting that together because he's my editor, and Skylar is raising her hand. She is the most polite audience. Skylar, Faith McGinnis. We went on a bike ride.
I went on a bike ride.
Tell everyone about that. What was special about this particular bike ride?
I didn't have training wheels.
You did say that louder? You didn't have training wheels. And what else? No training wheels, and what did I not do?
No.
I was not holding on. I know.
She's growing up. And this is a segment we like to call Skylar Faith rides her bike without training wheels all by herself.
You mean
the first time.
This? What?
That's my girl. Oh, showboat.
Look at that stop, too. That was awesome.
I love it. That's a big deal.
That's a huge deal.
I learned how to ride my bike in Maplewood, New Jersey, after Dad kind of pushed me and I went along my way carefully at first. I never came back. I loved riding a bike. And especially Skylar's a little bit like me, so she likes to sort of make up songs and be in her head about things. And anyway, I would ride and ride and ride and write songs and make musicals. And did I mention that Betty Lou and Neil would only let me ride up and down the cul-de-sac, so I could only go in one big circle over and over and over until I was 17? So that explains a lot of the therapy. No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding. Okay. We're going to let you go. Wisconsin is on. Pasadena is on. Oh my gosh, North and South Carolina is on. Woo, woo, woo. Chicago is on. Los Angeles is on. This is so exciting. Thanks for checking in with us. Oh my gosh. Old Maplewood friends are on. Hi, Fred. How are you? Sharla, hi. It's going to be a great night. We're really excited. Okay, other things I wanted to tell you about today. Where's my little note here? We rode a bike and then we started prepping for the rest of the week. And tomorrow we have a really packed show. So these shows have been 30 minutes, sometimes a little bit less. But tomorrow is going to be a little bit longer. So we'll Thursday show. We have surprises for you on Thankful Thursday. I'm checking in with some people that even, well, you don't know who we're checking in with. And I'm very, very excited about that. And then Fun Friday will be like a recap episode. But I also wanted to tell you in the comments tonight that for the show on Saturday, you can request, if you want to, request any specific songs for you. I've got a few in mind that I'm going to do. A lot of people want the stories behind the songs. I've covered about 110 songs on this show so far, so I probably got to the song that you were requesting. A lot. At least 70 I've done. I think I've done close to like 90 or 100, or bits of them. And if you call the, you know, 80s recap, that's a whole medley of 30 songs. Anyway, also we want to tell you that if you're liking what you're watching, please share. We would love for you to share. It's really simple. You can host a watch party, or you can just share it on someone's page. And that allows lots of other people to be able to tune in and watch the show. So speaking of, I'm happy because it's Bravo night. Okay, so if you know me, and you do by now, almost 70 episodes, I read a lot of books. I do. And I watch documentaries, and I get my news fix. But also, I am just absolutely a Bravo fan and have been for many, 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 many years. It got me through a lot of time on bed rest with Skylar Faith. A lot of good stuff to watch. I mean, I just dive in and I can't get enough of it. And the other thing we love about Bravo is that it's been a really groundbreaking network for a lot of reasons. A lot of the shows that they chose to air early on, just the way that they tell stories and the stories that they make relatable. So I couldn't be more thrilled with my Two for Tuesday tonight. These are two friends of mine that I've known for years. And I was actually thinking back, when I've been doing this and I've had a chance to reach out to my friends from all over the world now, I not only think of like, you know, where I've seen them or what I've seen them do, but I of course think back to when I met them and what we did together, if we've shared the stage a few times. And both of these guests that I'm going to have on tonight mean a lot to me, not just because they're talented and they're fun and they're funny, and engaging, but they're also good people doing good things. I've met both of them through my work with the Matthew Shepard Foundation, and both of them have helped me do benefits. One in New York City for Dan Melisergo for MSF, and then Scott several times for MSF, so including one in New York City at Birdland. So let me tell you about our first guest tonight. I'm really excited. You know him from the Emmy Award-winning Queer Eye for the Straight Guy, the original cast. He is an actor. He's a singer. He's a wonderful, wonderful person. He does so much. He hosts. He's funny. He's delightful. He's all over the place. And I am so glad that I get to show you a little bit of what he's been doing. So let me start with a little bit of his, this is a little something. Just watch. You're going to dig it. Just watch.
Hey, Julie. What's happening here? You can't be here. Did you ruin everything?
I'm driving and I'll go.
I'm not stupid. You're a cop. They have to let you go. I have to kill you.
The Rookie, new next Sunday on ABC.
It sure
we
is.
Love him. Oh my gosh. So that's pretty exciting. He's multi-talented. He was a TV personality when he was on Queer Eye, but he also is an entertainer. And so I asked him, since we did not have a musical guest this evening, I asked him if he would send us a little something, because at the benefit events that I've done with him, he has shared his beautiful voice. And so he was really nice to send us a little something. So let's listen to Jay do a little singing for you right now. You're going to love it. Lucky us.
Give me a million reasons to let you go. Give me a million reasons to quit the show.
Virtually, and so I'm doing some pre-recording stuff today as their MC, and I like to, you know, add a little glitter to the party when I host. So there you go.
I'm loving that we get you in all the glitter. So first of all, thank you for doing this. Thank you for sharing not just that awesome clip of The Rookie. That looks incredible. Very intense. Very different. The many faces of you.
Very different. Yes. And the face yes. You're getting now. I'm the man of many faces.
But also that beautiful song. It really touched me. I love seeing it. And so thank you for sharing that with us. Tell our friends that are watching right now and my people, where you are. Where are you calling in from tonight?
Yeah, so I'm calling from my bedroom in West Hollywood, California, and I watch you religiously. In fact, our mutual friend, Mary Beth, was the one who kind of turned me on to the fact that you were doing home shows. And it's really been such a like a cathartic, really beautiful time to continue performing. You know, I'm like essentially a gig worker. I jump from job to job, whether it's TV or cabaret when things are slow. And all of that is gone now. And to be honest, I was really feeling quite hopeless. Mm-hmm. And when you kind of sort of led this whole incredible movement of at-home entertainment, you were the first person. And I remember texting Mary Beth, and I was like, oh my God, but she's like all this fancy equipment. And you know, our friend Mary Beth, she sent me an early birthday gift. My birthday's in a month. And she sent me this like, basically an at-home karaoke system that I've been using. Yeah, it was just really, really cool to kind of you know, I never in a million years would I have thought that I've been doing home shows, but it's really been so emotionally vital for me as a performer, but also to be able to still give back, connect with audiences virtually.
Yes, well, I know. I've seen you pop up in your kitchen, and you're doing these shows. You sound incredible. I think you're using the karaoke machine that Mary Beth gave you, but your song list is incredible. People are watching you. You're hopping around, I think, from like Instagram over to Facebook. I mean, it's amazing. What were you? Go ahead. Well, before this happened, what were you doing? I mean, sort of, what were you doing before you got the word that it's not happening anymore?
Yeah. So for about a year and a half, I was hosting a morning show on the only nationally syndicated LGBTQ FM station. It actually exists in Nashville, where you are as well. But I was working and having so much promise in television that I just couldn't do both. Getting up at 4 a.m., going to bed at 8 p.m., just constantly having my nose in the news cycle was just too tricky while also trying to balance an acting career. So I left in December, and I was like, well, universe, here we go. I don't know what's going to happen. And I'll be honest, Randi, my first audition for anything in the new year was The Rookie. And I think just kind of walking in and knowing, okay, you're going to have to take a leap of faith and go in there and either get escorted off the property because they're so frightened of you, or you get the offer by the time you get to your car, and the latter thankfully happened. And I was really, really optimistic about 2020, and thankfully I had an opportunity to shoot Family Feud with my OG Queer Eye brothers and the new cast.
Tell me about this. It looks so great. Tell us about that. I'm excited. Ah!
So it was really exciting because I live in Los Angeles. Three of the boys live in New York, and one lives in Florida. We are never in the same room, all five. I think I can count on one hand since we wrapped, you know, like 13 years ago, how many times, or maybe it's 14 now. Actually, right now, May 2003 is when we began production on the original Queer Eye. So we're not often together, and it was just such a beautiful experience. And frankly, we've never really all been together with the new cast. So this was really a magical moment. And for ABC and Steve Harvey to celebrate all kinds of families was really impactful for us. And all I'll say is it airs this Sunday on ABC. Check your local listings. Mm-hmm. If you don't have regular TV, I'm sure it'll be on Hulu the next day or the ABC app. And all I will say is I'm really, really proud of how our team did. And, you know, we were both competing for charities that we felt passionate about. So, you know, it was just a full Fab 10 moment.
I love it. When I saw that was when you sent me that little blurb, I got so excited because it's such a, you know, it's such a testament to that show and how groundbreaking was. And now that it's been, you know, sort of reinvented, reincarnated, and it's just really touching a whole other group of people. I mean, it really should make you feel so proud of what you started and created.
Yeah, and Randi, I think you get this because I think it's all about really paying it forward. And when we stepped into this job, all of us had careers. I was on Broadway and Rent. I had taken a 6-month leave to do this great off-Broadway musical called Santa Don't, where I played the title character. And thought I was going back to Rent, just going to, you know, do Queer Eye during the day and the musical at night.
Right.
And then all of a sudden it exploded. And I think the optics of it, I think, was what I was struggling with, is knowing that, you know, I just did The Rookie and people know that I was on Queer Eye. And as I think this time has really done is it's kind of just kind of equal the playing field for everyone. And I think for gig employees, the optics are, oh, you were on Queer Eye. There's some massive residuals. We don't get anything like that. No residuals, nothing. And so it was culturally impactful. But also the kind of humility pill I had to swallow when I realized, okay, not eligible for unemployment, I have to really lead with the thing that got me into this business, which is really about being a storyteller and really wanting to uplift others. And if I have to entertain from my kitchen, you know, to pay my bills while we get through this, so be it. And thank you for really leading the way on that in such a beautiful, fun way, because it's like, it's appointment TV watching you. So thank you. I'm honored to be here.
You're so sweet. Well, I have been watching you do that. And so I've enjoyed, you know, just checking in with you, hearing you sing again, you know, that's been so amazing for me.
I know, because like I was telling you last night, I was so panicked because I had stepped away for a while and it was like tricky. And I think I, you know, when I was really a singer and queer, I hit and I moved to LA and I got this singing show on ABC. It was called Celebrity Duets. It's like Dancing with the Stars,
right?
But singing. And every week I've got a new celebrity partner. I thought, okay, great. I'm re-educating the world on who I am authentically as a performer. And then, you know, I just couldn't really make music happen as a profession. And so I just leaned back into television and stage work and touring with cabaret acts. And so you're like, he sent me something of you singing. And I was like, so anxiously petrified. I was like, what do I even have? But it's really challenged me, I think, a really beautiful way to get back to my roots as a performer in that space.
Art, you know, it's an incredibly interesting time. And we always say that we know how fortunate we are that we're healthy and that we're able to be safe in our homes, and we owe so much to the essential workers that are out there doing this. But I've been very impressed how arts rise up, you know, how artists find a way to create. We find ways to, you know, however it is, just whatever it is, we find a way to sort of figure it out and get it out there. And so I really appreciate, you know, finding you, reinventing yourself, and then reconnecting with you. It's been so great.
Let me tell you something shocking. So Broadway is pretty much shut down until 2021 right now. The last time this was even in the talks was 9/11 when I was in Rent. Mm-hmm. And the producers came to us at 7:15 on the Thursday. 9/11 was a Tuesday. Obviously dark that night, dark Wednesday, and we were back on stage at Rent for an audience of 30 tickets, I think, were purchased that day in a house that sat 1,200.
Wow.
And the producers said to us, in times of peril, in times where people are feeling so down, they don't know how to go on, it is your job as entertainers to uplift them and to, for just a short while, make them forget the outside world as much as they can, just to remember what it's like to feel joy. That is your job tonight. And while there are more people backstage and on stage than were in the house that night, I'll never forget that performance. Mm-hmm. And while we're all navigating this tricky time as artists, I do feel that is my job as a performer. And that's how I can give back right now.
Yes, and you are. And I'm so glad that you are. So first, tell us, will you go in the comments and put a link to something where we can find this stuff? Everyone's going to want to watch that Family Feud. I can't wait to see it.
Sure.
Follow you. And then also let us know, how often are you doing your lives so that we can check in with you?
I don't know how you've been able to do this so regularly, and kudos to you because it's a lot of work. So what I've been doing is going live Monday through Saturday, just having a good time connecting with fans on my Facebook, which is, if you just go to facebook.com, then go J. Rodriguez fan page, it's got a little blue check mark. That's when 5:00 Pacific Standard Time. And on Thursdays, that's when I basically do a live show. And then I start there and I do about 90 minutes on my Facebook. Then on my Instagram, it's just at my name, at J.A.I. Rodriguez. Mm-hmm. And then I go back to my friends and family Facebook, which is open to anyone to watch, for another 30 minutes. Because I get oddly more petrifying performing in front of friends and family than it is to people that are I haven't met all. I don't know why I save that for last. I get nervous.
No, well, that's awesome. That is quite a gig you got going there. Well, we will for sure check that out, put it in the links. Before I let you go tonight, we have been checking in with people from all over the world, and I like to sort of ask them the same kind of questions, just to kind of, you know, everyone's having, what do we say, the same experience, but we're all experiencing it very differently. So you can take these as light or as heavy as you want. First question, what's been the hardest part of this time for you of social isolation, the hardest part?
Probably my best friend testing positive, and for like 2.5 months, like he can't shake COVID, and he's like super healthy and doesn't drink, doesn't smoke, and is mid-30s and like doesn't fit the profile. And just to kind of see the fact, he is a, you know, performer, musical theater guy who makes his living as a hairdresser. And, you know, just to know that he's having this time where, You know, he's had two ER visits already. He's going to be fine. He's past the worst of it, but he just tested positive again last Saturday after 2.5 months. Mm-hmm. So it's not even like he can be around people or that he could mm-hmm. go back to work when we get to a time where, you know, it's just a scary time. I think that's been the hardest is like, your instinct is to want to comfort your friends and to want to be there. And when all you can do is drop off groceries or FaceTime, it really drives it on home. And certainly I'm sure a lot of people have it far worse than he's had it. It's just, it makes it close to home. And I think it really, just shows that honestly, it impacts everyone quite differently,
yes.
You know, than I guess what we thought.
Yes. And I appreciate so much for you sharing that. I really appreciate you sharing that with our audience. It's important, you know, people are viewing from all over the place and it's very different. And there are still people, quite honestly, and thank God for them, that don't know anyone that's had the virus or been affected. There are still people. So it's, you know, it's a sad but important reminder. Okay.
Well, you know, Randi, I actually just went and got tested. Like, I just had my routine blood work at my doctor's office, and they were testing everyone in your blood to see if you're, you know, if you had the antibodies, if you've been exposed. I haven't been exposed, so that was like a push-pull because I got the results today, and he was like, unfortunately, you were negative for antibodies, which means, you know,
but
I'm being optimistic and hopeful and doing my part. I'm wearing my mask.
I love it. Oh my gosh.
This is just the one
thing.
Mask
is
but
so
good. But I'm wearing
good.
A mask and washing my hands and treating everyone the way I'd like them to treat me. So.
Of course you are. Okay, well then our last question, I'll leave our viewers with, what would you tell them you've learned? What have you learned from this time?
You know, going back to Queer Eye, when we first started, I think one of the things that I learned, and I think the show highlighted, was how much more we are alike than we are different. And while our differences may be elevated depending on what we post or the way we present ourselves or how we identify or we choose to love, the fact of the matter is at our core, we're all so humanly connected. And I think this time more than ever before in my lifetime, that's been really, really at the forefront of everything that I viewed is that I think we all really, at our core, want the same basic things. And I think if we lead with love, we're one step closer to when we come out of this whole mess, feeling more connected as a global society. Because I think that's what this virus has kind of shown us is that we are all this global society, and leading with love is ultimately the answer.
Oh my gosh, I want to hashtag everything you just said. Yes, lead with love. I love global society. Yeah, well, thank you so much for not just sharing your time, your perspective. It's so good to see you again. I can't wait until this is over and I can hug you. And we can do a concert in a cabaret or in a kitchen. Let's just do it.
I would love it.
Let's
do it. I'm holding you to that. I love it because you live in Nashville. Reba lives in Nashville. We need a sitcom together.
There
I'll
you
visit you up as best. We'll make it happen.
Call me, Reba. Call me. All right. I love you. Take care. Stay safe. And we will check in and see you on Family Feud. I can't wait.
Sounds
all
good.
Right. Love
I'll
you.
I'll see you in the comment section.
Please do. I love you.
Love you. Bye.
So wonderful. Bye. Oh, Jake Rodriguez, Trailblazer. That show, you know, was so important. And, What wonderful perspective he had, you know, just really great to see him, great to see that he's doing these online prides, great to see that he's finding a way to come to you live from his kitchen, and thank you, Mary Beth, for making that happen. Hey, Zoe is on, so good to see you, Alexis is on, Shauna is on, hi, Rye, hi, Daniel, New Jersey's represented, oh my goodness, we're all over the place, Santa Fe, New Mexico is represented, Albuquerque's on, thank you so much for tuning in, well, it is 2 for Tuesday. You can see why this show makes my heart happy. It's going to be hard to not do it every night. It really is. Because this is, you know, no matter how we're feeling during the day, no matter what's going on, the fact that we get to check in with our friends and connect with them and hear how they're doing and, you know, to hear, so interesting, you know, him being tested today easily in California, apparently it seemed like, and then also his friend who's ill. A lot of you are putting in the comments that you know people suffering from it. It's just, you know, this is a safe space where we kind of process everything together, but it makes my heart feel good to have this connection. And so having said that, I want to bring on my second guest. Well, first I want to show you a little something from my second guest. So speaking of another person who is a wildly popular TV personality, wonderful host, a person who's helped me out several times when I've been doing some benefits for the Matthew Shepard Foundation, using his heart and his talent to pay it forward. And secretly, I'm such a fangirl on him because not only is he just a wonderful person to know, he's also on one of my favorite shows. So this is a big night for me. That's why I put on the false eyelashes. See, Are they staying on? This one's a little bit.
They look good.
But, big night over here. Big night for Randi. He was on a show called The People's Couch, which I just want to say, I thought I invented this show years ago because I would sit on the couch and I would pause every show that I watched 517 times and I would slap whoever I was watching it with. You know, if it was Andrew, it was usually Andrew. I was slapping Andrew and then I was talking back and I can't hear it and making comments. And then all of a sudden, poof, they made a show. It was phenomenal. I watched it all of the time and it gave me just such really good feelings. He's done so much more than that, but let's watch a little of my friend. This is Scott Nevins.
It's Scott Nevins. Hey, Scott Nevins. So fun to see your People's Couch back this week. I love your show so
it's
much.
It's like the little show that could.
It is.
People hear about it. They're like, it's the dumbest idea. And then they watch it, and they're like, this is amazing.
I agree.
We are here with the goddess of the red carpet and our hostess tonight, Joan Rivers.
Very excited to be here. It looks very exciting. It looks like it's going to be a big event.
And here's something people don't know about you. You smell delicious right now.
Thank you. Yes, I do. And it's my own perfume called Now and Forever that we no longer even make, but I have bottles of it in my basement.
I will sell it on Craigslist, whatever you need.
I will talk.
Hi, this is Scott Nevins, and we are here on the red carpet for the AFI Life Achievement Awards, honoring Michael Douglas. I am Scott Nevins, here with the beautiful Lisa Vanderpump, who outstaged everyone tonight with her outfit. Okay, so we're co-hosting together.
Yeah, exactly what I was about to say.
The People's Couch.
Whoa. It's time for Dancing with the Stars.
Goody, goody, Kimmy.
Oh, you're so sociological. I need subtitles with him.
I don't know. Did you need that? I needed that. That made me so happy. I can't even with that. It just made me so happy. He's a friend of mine. He does a lot of wonderful things, and he has some really incredible things going on right now that I want him to tell you about. So, should we knock on his door, Sky? Should we see if he's home? Because a lot of people are home. So let's see if my friend Scott Nevins is around and if we can catch him, because that would be awesome. Come and knock on our door. You're home!
I'm home.
We got lucky. We got very lucky.
I'm here, sitting in full hair and makeup with lights and a camera just at the right time.
Really, really. It's amazing. No coincidence. Oh, it's so good to see you. Okay.
Round of applause.
So, your whole intro just made me so happy. I have to be honest. That just thrilled me that I could get to see you do what you do. It just brought all the joy. So tell everyone that is watching, this is my friend Scott Nevins, tell everyone out there where you are calling in from.
All right, so I am in beautiful Palm Springs, California, where it is 106 degrees today. We have a house here. I live in Los Angeles. My fiance lives in San Francisco, and we have a house here. We decided just to shelter in place here because it's so beautiful, and we're so lucky. We have a house with a pool, so we knew we could suffer through this with some of the finer comforts of home.
No.
And but I'm originally from New York City, born and raised in Queens. Hello.
I know, so great. And your home is so beautiful, I've seen it. So tell us a little bit, tell my friends, what were you doing when this whole sort of shutdown happened, when everything sort of stopped? What were you up to?
I was sitting here with these lights and camera. Truth be told, I was preparing for our wedding.
Yes.
Our wedding was supposed to be on Saturday, March 21st, 2020, and we had to postpone it. And that meant everyone had to undo all their hotel reservations and their flights, and we had to call all the vendors and all that stuff. So it was a really interesting time because everything was ready, outfits, you know, everything was done, food, decor, and it's a sort of a big wedding, and it all just went away like that. It was gone.
I know.
And for us, it was an easy decision because we thought, you know, a wedding is just a celebration. We love each other. We live together. This is not going to change anything.
Right.
But you know what's funny? I did get a letter in the mail yesterday from Riverside County. They're like, you got a marriage certificate. You never had it like signed and returned. I was like, we didn't get married.
Aww.
So I think we have to do all of that.
And so did you, I don't even know this, truth be told. Did you postpone? Are you doing, like, are you just putting it off indefinitely, or what do you think?
So, breaking news, we postponed again 2 days ago. We were March 21st, and then we moved it to October 3rd, and we sat here this weekend, and I said, we both agreed, it's not going to happen
the way
we want it to happen.
It's heartbreaking, but I have to say, I can only imagine how you feel. It's heartbreaking, but how good of you to do the right thing. I mean, really. I mean, you really are.
Absolutely.
You're putting safety first.
Absolutely. That was our only concern, was like, what is the safety of our loved ones, of our guests? Like, what makes their lives easier? So we moved it back to March 2021. We're one day shy of one complete year later.
Oh, my gosh. All right. But you can send your gifts now if you'd like. That would be fun. No kidding.
Well, you know what's so funny? We did a no gift policy.
Oh, come on. So sweet. Are you rethinking it now?
Everyone is traveling. Philip's family is from England.
Yeah.
My family's from New York and all over the country. And we
thought,
we just want you there. We're so lucky. We have everything we need. We're we're so blessed, but we are.
No, yeah.
We're here. We're not starving. We don't need a blender.
So
just come and have fun with us.
But right now, during the quarantine, he's rethinking the blender. He's so now that you have been at your beautiful home in Palm Springs and kind of your personal life, you know, you sort of dealt with that. What have you been doing to sort of fill this time? What have you been doing professionally? What's been going on? Give me a little of that.
So, as you know, and some people watching may know, I was on a TV show called The People's Couch. We did 5 seasons, and it was so much fun. My 2 very close friends, who are also my guest stars on the show, my co-stars, I've been doing press for my since 7 a.m., so if I say something wrong, just go with me.
It's fine.
Not my guest stars, my co-stars on the show, and very good friends in real life, Blake and Emerson, came out here on the wedding that would have been, the weekend that would have been our wedding. I'm going to do that all again, ready? People's Couch on Bravo for 5 seasons. Big hit. My co-stars and good friends, Blake McGuire and Emerson Collins, decided they were going to do something very sweet and come out here to Palm Springs and be with Philip and I on the day that would have been our wedding. And because they were like me, they traveled with 18 pieces of luggage and 16 costume changes per day. So they got here, and as they arrived, our phones lit up, and it said that a shelter-in-place order was put in place in California. And Philip and I looked at each other, and we both knew. We were like, just stay here. We have this house. We have your own side of the house.
Mm-hmm.
And so we have been living the People's Couch. Every night, we cook dinner together, and then we watch TV. And we do some Facebook Lives on Wednesday and Thursday to watch The Real Housewives. And we do... What is it? It's Wednesday's Beverly Hills, Thursday's Real Housewives.
You do New York. I know
you
do New York.
East Coast
yep. Mm-hmm. So
and
fun.
It's been great.
Okay, so I have to tell you the truth. When I saw the first one, I watched it and I was like, wait, what are they doing quarantined? Like, he's the only television show that got quarantined together? What's going on? Like, is the cast of Friends suddenly quarantined in the same place? What's happening? And then you explained it to me and I thought it was actually so sweet. And so interesting that now, you know, what came from something really beautiful, them wanting to just be friends, then turned into this thing that, hey, you can sort of reboot this show that, by the way, I love, and I've been watching, and you can do it, and direct it, and produce it, and pretty much be in your own home. It was kind of amazing. It made me laugh so hard. I loved it.
Well, it's funny, Randi, because, you know, I've been watching you do all these shows 900 days a week, 900 shows a week. And I'm always like, how are they doing this many shows? We do 2, and then Emerson has his shows, Blake has his cocktail happy hour. I mean, it is, this is quarantine studios here in Palm Springs.
Yeah.
So we're just churning out. Listen, here's what's coming up, by the way. This is not a joke. Emerson is hosting and producing a huge celebrity reading of Sorted Lives, Del Shore's play.
Yes.
Leslie Jordan.
Breaking news.
Caroline
right
Ray. Tons of cars, right?
Yes.
That's
yes.
happening from the bedroom over there.
Okay.
That is this
we call
weekend.
That
you should
studio,
check it out.
Studio
Colin.
A.
It's
we
so
call
good.
That. Studio A.
Then I am producing and hosting a celebrity live stream for an amazing organization called Desert AIDS Project here in Palm Springs. And it's Kristen Chenoweth, Betty Buckley, Matthew Morrison, Megan Hilty, and Brian Gallagher.
Yes.
Anne Hampton Calloway, Max von Essen, Eric Bergen, Seikon Sandblow, Blake and Emerson, Carla Jimenez, and Christina Bianco, and me, all performing.
That's going to be insane.
Friday, June 5th. So Friday, June 5th, that's happening. We're raising money for Desert Ace Project. That's happening here in the house.
That's
and
incredible.
On the interwebs. And then Saturday, we're not done. Saturday, Blake is doing a live version of his like hit one-man show called Blake Sings Barbara. And it's an amazing concert for anyone who is obsessed with Barbara Streisand's 94 concerts. Remember when she came back after like 28 years of not performing?
Yes.
He does a beautiful, beautiful, loving rendition of the show where he mixes in personal stories, does all the songs she did. It's amazing. And that is happening right here behind you. So we're no joke in this house. We are quarantine studios.
It's happening. It's woo, we're churning them out. It's happening. I know. Isn't it amazing though that I was just talking about this with Jay Rodriguez, who says hi, by the way. We were just talking about how arts, you know, survive. They thrive and they survive. And everyone that you and I both know collectively and all the people I just see out there are finding ways to do it. They're just finding ways to make this happen. We didn't expect this is what it would look like. We had no idea that we'd be producing from Studio A is your bedroom and Studio B is your kitchen, you know, and the green room is your guest bathroom. But it actually is really, it makes me so happy and it gives me hope, you know, because everyone's just chugging along, right? It's what we do.
Absolutely. And, you know, listen, here are some of my favorites, right? There's Jim Crusoe doing Cast Party, doing Pajama Cast Party.
Pajama Cast Party. It's so good, right?
You guys are killing it with, like, your, I love you have adult content and then you have, like, child content.
Yes.
That's amazing. You know, Emerson and Blake, everyone is, Marty Thomas on Monday nights is doing these Diva Live, everything. This is how artists survive, right? Because nobody is making any money right now. So if you do watch these things and you have a few extra dollars, please Venmo your hosts, send them some money. You can send me all of your money. I will watch over it.
Also a bank, a studio and a bank. Good to know. What's the interest rate over there?
Yes.
I'm so thrilled that all you're doing, that Palm Springs event sounds incredible. When I saw that lineup, I was just really...
Can I break in?
Can you break in? Yeah. Oh, the cameraman all of a sudden.
Jim Crusoe just said, oh, hi. So he's on watching you watch her watch. It's very confusing.
We're all in the same
place. I love Jim Crusoe. No, truly, that man is like, that is the heartbeat of New York right there, Jim Crusoe.
It's very true. And it was really interesting because, you know, I mean, Cast Party's a staple. And so wondering, I mean, it's so much about showing up and standing in line and waiting your turn and going up and singing and meeting and hugging. And it's been so interesting to watch him sort of move over to this online space that we're all doing. But I don't know about you, but for me, it makes me feel better. It doesn't matter what kind of a day I'm having. And we've had some really rough days because even though, you know, when the phones go on, you know, we sort of turn it on and we do what we're supposed to do. Up until that point, many days, I've been sad and really lost, and there's something about this time together, though, this community, that makes me feel better, and I know that that's just what, you know, that's what this is all about, so, and you're one of those people that makes me feel better. I'm so glad that you're here. I really appreciate that you've been in contact with me and that we've been able to make this happen. I want to ask you the hard-hitting, you know, the Oprah questions. Here we go. No, not at all. But take them as light or as heavy as you want. I do ask them of all the guests, pretty much, because I like getting a perspective, because everyone's going through something, but we're just all going through it different ways, different times, different parts of the country. So what, for you, would you say has been the hardest part of this time? What has been the hardest part of social isolation?
Okay, so you're breaking up a little bit. Probably my Wi-Fi because we have so many shows happening. Did you say what is the hardest part?
Yes, the hardest. Yeah.
The hardest part is, you know, obviously the wedding was rough, right?
Yeah.
Canceling the wedding, postponing it. But for me, the hardest is like I travel a lot as this Philip, and I go to New York City a lot because my mom is there and my family's there,
right.
And great friends like Jim Crusoe and Max von Essen and Eric Bergen and,
mm-hmm.
you know, Nick Adams, all these people who want my feet there, we just get together and I'm like, oh, this feeds my soul. And I can't do that, right? I don't want to do it right now. I can't get there. And I can't get to them. I see them some days feeling sad.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I feel like that with everybody. The hardest thing is trying to be a source of positivity and light and humor finding the humor, and that is what performers, especially comedians and hosts and stuff, are supposed to do. And it's hard right now to find it, because I also get angry at people who, like, don't wear their masks and believe misinformation. And they're like, oh, well, I have the antibodies on. It's like, no, we're not 100% sure of that yet. Like, just be respectful of other people and wear your mask. Let's look at Japan and look at how, when they wear masks, how they bring their numbers down.
Yes,
and
I feel you. And I agree, the traveling, I know that you hop the coast all the time. I know that you do. I've watched you do it. And I found myself talking to my suitcase the other day. I was just talking to her. I was like, we will be together soon. Not now, but soon. Okay, well then, let's leave them with the flip side of that. Let's leave them with something positive, like you just said. What has been the silver lining for you of this time? The silver lining that you found?
Okay, one selfish answer, and then
yes.
The real answer.
No, go ahead.
The selfish answer is that I found out that my fiancé, Philip, can cook and bake. I didn't know this.
That's not selfish.
Suddenly, he's making these amazing meals. Emerson looks at me and goes, did you know he could cook?
Bonus!
He's been eating like kings. It's unbelievable. He's so great. Besides that, the other positive thing for me is sort of confirming what I've always known, which is there's like two types of people, right? There's the types that fall apart in a disaster and the types that rise up and lead. And people like you guys and Jim and Marty and all these people doing these things are really rising up to lead. And I'm very proud of people who aren't in the public life, who are putting themselves out there, whether it's just the Pope saying, hey, like, these are the facts, you should wear your mask, or, you know, hey, my neighbor is 90 and needs food, can someone come together? Watching communities, after all the division we've had in the country, watching communities come together to take care of each other restores my hope in this country in such a way that is so profound and makes me feel proud, once again, to be an American.
Yes.
For those people that are doing it, for the ones that are filling up beaches and screaming at reporters, I'm done with you, I don't know you, I don't know your name, I don't know your life, but those who are doing it correctly just by staying home and speaking truth, I worship at your feet. I think you're magnificent. Please don't stop speaking out.
Yes, thank you for your perspective. I will say before we let you go that that's part of the reason that we started doing this little live was honestly, Scott, to connect people with information because, you know, I live in Nashville, but my roots are New York, New Jersey, and California. So it was kind of a way to hear, oh my gosh, what's happening in New York? Wait, what's happening in California? Wait, what is not happening in Nashville right now? And so I really appreciate everyone giving their truth, their honesty, and their perspective, because I think it helps when you hear someone talk about a person they knew or what they're going through or what they see. I think it really helps. It's important that we share. So that's another reason why using some form of technology to sort of stay in the now is really important, you know. So I appreciate you so much. I've always appreciated when you've come through and hosted for us and worked with Judy for the Matthew Shepard Foundation. But I'm really glad you're doing this stuff, and I'm really happy that you're safe. I'm so sorry about your wedding, but next year, I mean, a year later,
yes.
A year better, bigger, better, bolder.
Yes.
Bigger
now, I
cake.
Know you're on a schedule, but do I not get questions from the audience? Because Jay Rodriguez got questions.
Did he get a question from the audience? Or did he just get a question?
Were they just from
well,
you?
Let me see. No, they were just from me, but hold on. Let me see. You know.
You're my last appointment of the day, so I can see.
Okay,
you.
Hold on. Questions from the audience. Oh my gosh, that's adorable.
Nobody wants to know a thing about me. It's fine. I'm going to go home and cry now.
Oh, well, okay, so I had one private message of someone that wanted a tour of your house, but I don't think we have time for that. But I think, but no.
We got a question.
No, but wait. Before we get to the question, the cameraman's letting me know there is a question. But before we get to that, somebody thought it was a green screen, and I said, no, that's your house. That is not a green screen. Yeah. All right. Okay, we have a question from the audience. Go ahead, Andrew.
Scott, this is coming from New York City and a gentleman named Jim Caruso.
Yeah.
He wants to know, who are you wearing?
Yeah, who are you wearing?
Jim. What am I wearing? Oh, I should know this. Hold on. Tell me
what
I'm wearing.
That's not Target.
No. Ted Baker.
Ted Baker.
Sorry.
She's playing with you.
Ever since this started, my word.
brain does not work anymore.
No.
Like,
no,
I can't remember names. I can't remember, like, no, but I mean, like,
no.
I was talking to my mom and I asked her how my brother was, and I was like, how's, she's like, Ryan? I was like, Ryan, how's Ryan? Like, it's crazy.
Oh my gosh. Okay, someone wants you to know that Colin, who's watching from Pennsylvania, it's not a question, it's just a comment, went to high school with Nick Adams. So hopefully you know who Nick is.
Nick
okay,
Adams
good.
So much. He's disgustingly handsome. He should be arrested for being that handsome.
Well, then we should all know Nick Adams, okay?
What people don't know is that he's one of the nicest, sweetest guys in the world. I mean, I adore that man. He's so great.
And I will say that that's been one of the really nice things in being a musician that travels all the time and meets people. The circle of friends that I met, I was explaining to Andrew many years ago through Jim and through MSF. And, you know, the circle was a wide circle of all really kind people. And it makes me really happy because I continue to have relationships with them. And in times like this, that matters a whole lot, too. You know, I mean, it's great if you can, you know, big notes are awesome and big funnies are awesome. But if you've got this going on too, then that really, as we're seeing right now, it makes all the difference. And so I just love you. I am so glad you were here with us tonight. Thank you so much. Tell me, because I actually want to know, like, immediately, what Housewives are you doing next and when can I watch it? Are we doing that? When are we doing that? Is that coming back?
Sure. So tomorrow night is Real Housewives
yes.
of Beverly Hills.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And then...
Mm-hmm.
Thursday is Real Housewives of New York, and then this weekend is Emerson's live stream, and then comes Voices of Hope, the one that I'm producing, and then Emerson's show is Saturday the 6th. So, lots happening here, kids.
Okay, okay. And then, as soon as this is over, we'll be coming out to your beautiful home, because I see that piano, I can play it, you've got the pool,
yes.
I feel like it's calling. See what I just did there? I just invited myself.
You just invited us to Palm Springs.
I did.
Wait a minute. Randi never told me that.
Oh, no,
I'm upset now.
It was really just for me. It was a time to recharge.
Yeah, she kept saying solo, and I was like, please.
Yeah. Thank you, Scott.
Family.
Oh, my gosh. Well, you're getting so much love from the people watching, people hoping that they will see you, you know, out and about and at one of the MSF galas in the future, no matter who knows what those are going to look like, the big charity events that we all do, who knows. But until I see you in real time, hug all of those beautiful people that you're with. I've appreciated you. Keep doing all the beautiful stuff and go in and put the links up for the event so that people can follow the, especially the Palm Springs charity event that you're doing. That's really fantastic. And I know people will want to log in and watch, okay?
Yeah, and then it's easy enough. You can go to desertaidsproject.org/hope.
Okay.
H-O-P-E.
DesertAidsProject.org/hope. We got it. Awesome.
Yes.
Thank you for doing
that. Oh, I love you guys so much. Thank you for letting me come on and have fun with you.
Oh, my God. We love you. Anytime. I will see you soon, okay? Big hugs.
Yeah.
Go have an amazing dinner that I know he's cooking you. Okay.
Yes.
That's my friend, Scott Nevins. He's wonderful. He makes me laugh. Oh, and I did love that show so much. And I'm so glad they're doing it. It's super fun. They watch the show. I don't know if they watch the show, and so you kind of have to be watching the show, but I do. So the trick is getting it live when they're watching it. It's super fun. It's just people chatting, like having a little popcorn, or last week it was Cheez-Its, and I'm lucky. I know great people. This was such a fun night. I'm going to do a little bit of a song because we're running over, so I'll just do a little blip of something here. And I want to say thank you to my friends who watched. This is it. This is our countdown. We've got, tomorrow night is Wednesdays with Women We Love, and I have some amazing women, people that I've known for a long time that have worked with me and done music with me, and then I have something super fun. I have a connection with a new friend that I made, and it's going to be a fun story that I get to share with you. That's Wednesdays with Women We Love with wine. I always add the wine part. That's just really for me. This eyelash is not, I mean, it made it like 40 minutes, eyelashes, because it's too producing. And then Thursday, we have Thankful Thursday. I have a surprise guest who I've been hoping to get on for 60-some episodes, and I'm finally going to have my friend on. And let's see, I'm going to check in with other people doing really good things and tell you about the people out there that are making a difference. And then finally, Fun Friday will be our sort of wrap party. We're going to have a wrap party, and you're all invited. So if you've been liking these, share them. Saturday, I'll be doing a house concert live from our living room. And I'm just so grateful. It was a really great night for me. They've all been great nights. They always make me feel better. So this was a request. It's an old song, so I'm just going to do a little bit of it. It's an old song, but we'll sing it anyway. Here we go.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
60-some episodes that Child has been vlogging. She was doing some sort of interpretive dance over here. You couldn't see it. It was beautiful. There was, like, this happening, and there was this thing. That's the war. It's from my first full two-act CD. That's right. It's a two-act CD. Double record, if you will. Not really called the play. And Larry Mitchell produced it, and it was a... it meant a whole lot to me. It was a pivotal thing, because I went from being on a label to not being on a label to doing it myself. And that's just like what we're doing now. We're doing it ourselves. Okay, we had a great night. Thanks for being with us. Really big hugs and thanks to Jay and Scott. Check out what they're doing. Amazing things. They're paying it forward. They're doing tons of charity stuff. They're just giving back, like they always did, and everyone's finding a way to do it now. Check out all my friends that are online doing really great things and making a difference and finding a way to power through. If you are in one of the places that are opening up right now, and that you're a business that's been closed for so long, our hearts are with you. We know it can't be an easy decision. We know it's not easy. So thank you for doing it and doing it correctly and keeping people safe. And if you're out and about for the first time, if you're going to a restaurant for the first time, we honor your journey. And we're thinking of you and hoping that everyone just does right by everyone else. Skylar has something she wants to say to you. Your...
Life
attracts your
tribe.
Oh, we love
our tribe.
We do love you. Check in tomorrow. Follow us on YouTube. Subscribe to my channel. And we will see you. Thanks a lot. Have a great night. We'll see you tomorrow for Wednesdays with Women.